morning, everyone. I'm Qasem Shalan from the Lebanese Red Cross. Glad to be here to present Lebanon and Lebanese Red Cross. The Lebanese Red Cross, a humanitarian organization founded in 1945, comprises around 10,000 volunteers and 350 staff. Our goal is to promote peace, serve the society, and alleviate human suffering without any discrimination. Most people might think of GIS simply as online map, feature layers, or navigation system. But ArcGIS tools do a lot more than helping organizations get from A to B. Humanitarian organizations are adding a special dimensions to data to help a critical to make a critical decision in these tough and critical environments like our region. Find out more about this topic with my colleague Shaheen and why LRC business with special data is so much more than just a feature layer.
So how does GIS integrated with differ from traditional GIS approach? A typical spatial approach to GIS data is about land use and optimization of that. Where to put the next emergency ambulance station, health center, etc. Well, on the one hand, this is true. But there is a place for standalone GIS apps to do just that. But the power of GIS is far greater. Land use changes. Where you put a station or a branch today may not be that ideal in 5 years' time. However, what action can you take based upon your now relatively may affect your network? How do you meet the changing landscape of vulnerable people and reply to their needs? How do you optimize the distribution channel that you have? How do you accurately compare one station performance with another based on mission segments analysis? Not necessarily proximity. Still a spatial question, believe it or not. This is a greater reality of ArcGIS data and the massive potential that it has for improving business performance. What are the same of the newer and more innovative ways in which organizations are using GIS data beyond traditional methods? When you think of GIS traditionally, you think of government and urban planning. The major application in the humanitarian sector to date has been logistics. However, this is changing. One of the key uses of GIS is a station, branch, resources location. Many great partners of ours does just that, but there is a whole lot more. The most compelling is the use of spatial data for optimizing health, medical, humanitarian, and relief services. Understanding the demographics of the desired community and where they are located is critical if you want to maximize the return of your services. It's not just about being able to target them, but also understanding what the likelihood of them, what is needed from your side, how your contribution will help them. Blood transfusion services at LRC has a fantastic use of ArcGIS. They are using spatial analytic capability of ArcGIS to boost blood donor recruitment from 2,000 blood drive donations last year, to 7,000 donations this year, as expected, with a yearly exponential growth. By tracking the blood drive request, blood transfusion services can overlay not the location of the blood drive itself, but all the demographic breakdown of the location population. These are highly valuable services to their patients, who can now accurately measure the effectiveness of response rates to their blood needs from a spatial perspective.
Where do we go from here? As expected, in 2019, we'll be launching our own solution for digital enhanced vulnerability capacity assessment, or what's called DEVCA, in order to make communities more resilient through the assessment and analysis of the risks they are facing and identifying solutions to address this. The following solution will be fully deployed using the ArcGIS Hub for Communities Engagement, Operational Dashboard, and GeoEvent Technology. In parallel stage, we'll be adding more features to our current dispatch system by integrating it with GeoEvent for real-time ambulance tracking and automated mission assignment based on the mission location, mission type, and mission critical level. In the quality improvement side of blood product, we'll be deploying the monitored and secured blood product delivery from centers to hospital using props and sensors connected to GeoEvent that capture temperature in real time and raise alert to ensure the transfusion of safe blood product. All this innovation will be possible using ArcGIS. LRC started out as a pure play BR presentation. Why did LRC get into GIS? And when did LRC make the leap? LRC stands for Lebanese Red Cross. As LRC, we're doubling around, and we got a taste of how communities are formed and interact. We have developed an impressive data warehouse for our ambulance services, medico-social services, and blood transfusion services. But little focus was placed on the spatial side of BI. It was left to a separate department that concentrated on branch development and service optimization. We did a little work with them and became fascinated by why some of branches were more than successful than others. Such a large part had to do with geography. Yet, this information was never integrated into manager's view of branches' performance. However, organizations have whole departments that specialize in geospatial business question, and yet this department are rarely integrated into general business intelligence. And this we see it as a major gap. We came to a fundamentally believe that along with time, spatial data is a common and highly relevant dimension for any organization. So in the context of ArcGIS and Power BI, we got excited when last year we had project managers coming to us who really understood the interaction between Power BI and spatial data and wanted to see the ArcGIS spatial data integrated into BI. It was working with this project that we really decided to take the plunge and develop our own native GIS functionality within Power BI to ensure its tight fit into BI.
So how is GIS being integrated with business intelligence? It's really happening with ArcGIS and Power BI. This is location intelligence, as we call it. Simply another facet of our core application. It can access spatial data from variety of feature layers and provides map exported and maps report either through its dashboard or as a web services. These services allow us to embed these maps into things like SharePoint, Microsoft Dynamics, or any other application. This approach is different than traditional GIS. It's really mapping for the whole organization with advanced analytical approach. Analysis is where the big payoff on GIS arises, and it's where ArcGIS intelligence solution using the different platform from operational dashboard tools, insights tools, and web app builder tools, and Power BI tools. So what are the main ArcGIS enhancements, and what does this mean for LRC users? I will let the short movie answer the question. Let's watch.
البروجرام حقيقه سهل كثير شغل علينا. اول شيء كل المعلومات اللي بدنا اياها نحن موجوده, في عنا تشويس نقدر نختار, ما فينا غير نكتب الرقم, اسم المريض وعمره, وهوديك كلياتهم باي تشويس, والحلو فيه كمان هذا البروجرام اللي كمان انا لقيته ملفت للانتباه غير البروجرام القديم، انه الفولونتير اوقات على عجقتها يمكن ما تفهم خط الحكيم، يمكن ما تعرف تكتب كل الدواء، هون نحن الادوية دغري اول ما نحط اول حرفين الدواء دغري نزل عنا، بس بنحط الكوانتيتي اللي له. فلقيته كتير حقيقة حلو، لانه اكتر شيء كمان بقدر اخر الشهر نطلع جردة الدواء اللي عم نشتغلها، وعم يكون نحن على الارض عم نعرف قدي عم نصرف، شو بدنا نحن اخر الشهر لنطلب من الصيدلية.
ما في شك انه اعتماد التقارير الممكننة عبر نظام الجي اي اس سهل كتير بتجميع الداتا بشكل
So DGS belong integrated into core system and applications such CRM ERP. As LRC, we think that just like GIS and BI counterpart, these are not a core system and are better integrated into application. LRC specializes in providing now an embeddable ArcGIS and BI tools for its management and project. Our solution now is easy to integrate and designed to support all type of data to rapidly bring spatial analysis to their community-based services. To many organization decision makers, having such a wealth of internal and external information available at a short notice and within a single frame for analysis seems almost impossible dream. It is, however, a fact that ArcGIS enhanced BI can and has made this dream a reality for many organizations. So imagine the possibilities. Thank you.